Hello and welcome to Hybees TV. Today we have Mr. M. Ramakrishna, who is the founder and managing director of Maitri Aquatech Private Limited. Hello sir, welcome to Hybees TV. And first of all, we just wanted to start with, where did you got the idea of developing this product?
I'm a mechanical engineer, passed in 1988, then worked with companies like Kirloskar and Arvind and a lot of other companies, and before starting my business, and I started working on this machine way back in 2010, and 2010 to 2016 we did work on this machine in a different models, different technologies, we tried to stabilize, and 2016 we incorporated the company, and 2018 May we installed our first machine in Indian Institute of Chemical Technology.
So why did you call your machine as Meghdoot?
The idea behind the whole machine is only because of the problem of water being faced by everybody. The women were facing, the children were dying, and there were a couple of droughts in Rajasthan and all that, where a lot of people died. And I thought that we could have avoided had we used some technology, because technology was very much there and I'm aware of it. So we so many lives getting lost just because the government is not proactively working. That's where I felt that let me do my bit. And that's how the whole idea came, and I started working on it. And the large number of deaths that are happening in the country of children is because of water contamination. You will be surprised to know, almost 80% of the diseases that children have are waterborne diseases. And 50% of the hospital beds in the world are by waterborne diseases. So there is a requirement of good potable water. And on the one side, we talk about requirement of good potable water. But there are a lot of articles which appear and tell that there is more water in the air than in the ground today. And there is a large perennial source of water available in form of atmospheric humidity. And one interesting fact is that condensation technology, which we use to take water from the atmospheric humidity, the first patent has come in 1910. So, for the last 110 years, the world is aware of a condensation technology, but somehow for reasons not known, nobody has bothered to commercialize it. Only off late some of the countries like Israel and all that have started working on it. So, I also started working on this. I felt there is so much that can be done. I started working on this technology way back in 2010. But I was doing it slowly, not knowing how much will be the acceptance in the country and all that. But it so happened that Honorable Prime Minister in 2015 has gone to Israel. And there he spoke to one company in the similar technology. And he wanted to bring that technology to India. So then I realized that we have been working on this technology for so long. Why can't we build this in India? So we started commercializing it and all that. And 2016 December, we incorporated Maitri Aquatech Limited, and which is basically we manufacture atmospheric water generators in the name of Meghdoot. And then what has happened, the world is talking about this technology as an engineering item. But what I realized, we need this machine only for giving clean potable water. And the water that we get from the machine is a clean water without any minerals, because it's a DM water. You are only condensing the atmospheric humidity, you are not adding any mineral. So we partnered with Indian Institute of Chemical Technology, filed a joint patent, and then for remineralizing the water. So we came out with the world's first remineralized water, atmospheric water from the atmospheric water generator, way back in 2017. And the first machine was installed in Indian Institute of Chemical Technology in the year 2018, May 1st. And today, we are the only company approved by Ministry of Jal Shakti, and also we are on the website of Ministry of Jal Shakti.
So what was the reaction of the people when your product has been launched into the market?
Meghdoot is, Megh is cloud. The sky is the, Doot is the messenger. So it's a cloud, our water is also coming from the cloud. Actually, we almost follow the rain cycle. What we see in the normal rain cycle is water getting evaporated from sea or a surface water and then getting into cloud and then again coming back onto the ground in the form, but dew point it gets separated and the water comes. Same thing we follow. We almost do the same thing mechanically. We take the air from the atmosphere, condense it. At a dew point, we separate, the water gets separated, the air goes back into the system, dry air goes back into the system, the humidity gets converted into water, and then we add minerals and all that, and then convert it into potable drinking water.
So many people had told you about this machine that it would not work. So how did you deal with that?
People did not believe it. lot of people said it is the magic. Some people said it is not possible. Some people said it is not sustainable. And many of them are telling that it will produce a liter or a half liter. When we put our first machine of 1,000 liters per day, then at Indian Institute of Chemical Technology, a lot of people came and a lot of people used to only visit Indian Institute of Chemical Technology to see our machine. So, but slowly over a period of time, when people started seeing the result, they started believing. Bharat Electronics Limited has put our machine in the defense show, and our machine was inaugurated by the Combined Defense Staff, presently Combined Defense Staff, Mr. Bipin Rawat, at that time Chief of Army Staff, has inaugurated our machine. And then from there, we have today almost 200 plus installations all over the country, and the enough proof of concept now. People were not willing to believe that this machine can produce large quantities of water. Then when we started putting a 1,000 liter machine, we came out with a 2,000 liter machine. Then consistently I used to check day in, day out the output. And then for 6 months, 9 months, the machines were running and we were getting the water. And then we used to get the water tested by every known laboratory in the country. And when we got the results, that's where I got the conviction that we are in for something big. At the same time, we have to understand one thing today. World doesn't have a source of water. See, there's no groundwater. And we are over-exploiting the groundwater. And wherever the water is, it is all contaminated. So there is the issue of quantity of water, there is an issue of quality of the water, and we need an alternative source. We don't have an alternative source, and people are forgetting the fact that atmosphere have more water than what we have today. Other than the sea, we have a lot of water in the billions and billions of liters of water is there in the form of humidity. And one fact is that 0.01%, if we condense of atmospheric humidity, that will be enough for the entire mankind for 1 year. 0.01%. And another interesting fact is the air, that humidity in the air get replenished several times, because it evaporates again, it picks up from the sea, it get replenished. So you can be rest assured this is a perennial source. You are saving the groundwater. Unlike in Arvo, you are not wasting the water and you are adding the mineral, and it's a perennial source. And the beauty is our machine can run on solar and wind also. So you can be 100% green solution. So that what we say, Panchabhuta, we are only using that.
What was the capacity of the first machine when you had been launched?
See, when we started with the big machine, but now we have 30 liters, smallest household machine. Like people are gifting their grandchildren and children during COVID time our machines for health. Instead of giving them a gift of gold, people are telling that instead of giving a gold or money, we will give them a machine which will be much more good thing for the rest of their life than what. So today people are gifting this machine, 30 liter, 20 liter machines for the their grandchildren or in the families are buying. Two, we have up to 5,000 liters, and we have a proposal to put up a 1 million liter plant in Uganda. And also in Cape Town in South Africa, we are planning to put a 1 million liter plant.
What was the support you just got from the government in getting better acceptance for your product?
See, that is the, I will say the sad part of the story is that I got almost every minister has tweeted about that, including Honorable Minister for Railways has tweeted that this is the best water. We have put up our machine railways and rest of the government. Jal Shakti Ministry themselves have approved it. It is there on the portal of Jal Shakti. And today when we are telling to the world that here is the best source of water. This water can be alkaline water. So there is, and this water can be plain pH balanced water. Government has not even responded. So we are only trying to proactively reach out to them, but not even the kind of support we otherwise we expect from the government to come and say that okay, we will support you. See, when we are talking about Atmanirbhar Bharat, when we want to talk India to a global level, here is the technology which India can become the world leader, and India has the population. And if the growth of India is not possible without India being water secured. And water security means healthier India. Healthier India means more self-reliant India. So the today there is an urgent need for the government to support the policy way in terms of through subsidies, through buying, and through incentivize this usage of these machines. The way they have incentivized solar and all that, they should also incentivize atmospheric water generator companies.
Can you tell the locations of your product with where it has been installed and where it has been into use from all these days?
We have put the first machine, though we have got a lot of installations, through CSR activity we have put in Abdul Kalam Memorial Trust in Rameshwaram. We have put in Dwarka Temple in Gujarat. But for a public consumption, and we have put it in Secunderabad Railway Station, where we have got two machines, almost 5,000 liter capacity. And that is the first place. And today we have a mandate we can put up in another 1,000 stations in the country.
So basically, how much water does a human being need for a day?
See, the normally the person requires around 4 to 5 liters of potable water per day. So you get around 20 liters of this. So I am very confident that if the government gives us the support and all that, we will be able to meet at least 8 to 10% of the requirement of the country through alternative sources of AWG, atmospheric water generator.
So what is the difference between the water we get from our water board and the water you generate from your machine?
See, we use a technology called condensation technology, which is very, very common in the mechanical engineering. The machine sucks the air from the atmosphere, and then it condenses the air to a level of dew point. When the condensation happens at a dew point, generally what happens, the water separates out of the air, and the hot air is going on, and the whatever water is collected, because it is not having any minerals and all that, and there can be some suspended particles and all that at the dew. So we pass through set of filters, after passing them through set of filters, we also do the ozonization, and we also have the ultraviolet lights and all that. And then post that, we do the dosing. And the dosing is a mechanism through which we add the minerals to the water. And then the water becomes one of the purest water with all the electrolytes which are required for the healthier body. And the pH of the water will be around 7.5. And the beauty of the system, and the biggest appreciation point, is this is decentralized. It can be anywhere. A house can have it, two houses having next to each other, they can have a separate system. It's a decentralized. And it's a totally, it doesn't touch the groundwater at all. So it's 100% dependent on the atmospheric humidity. And the power source can be grid, it can be run diesel, it can be solar, it can be hybrid, any power source. In a national disasters and all that, we use the diesel generators to give water, and the water is fully remineralized. The moment water touches the ground, there is a problem of microbe, E. coli and all that, the bacteria will be there and all that. And then there are a lot of heavy metals in the water, like we have in Srikakulam, uranium traces, in Nalgonda we have fluoride, entire East India we have arsenic. So those and many of them cannot be treated through RO water plant. And to clear them, what RO water does, when they take 2 liters of the groundwater, finally, after treating all that, it's only 1 liter which comes, close to 1 liter of the water which comes. Again, all the important minerals have been taken out of it. So the water that we get is not a very, very high healthy water, because the TDS will be very low of 17, 18 and all that. pH can be around whatever it is, 7.5 or whatever. But in our case, because we don't touch the ground, there are no microbes, bacteria there. So there is no contamination possibility at all, number one. Number two, we have a perennial source. And when we make 1 liter, we save 2 liters of groundwater, because we are not only taking water from the air, we are also, the water that we have taken from the air will help to recharge the ground. And we are adding minerals. And the water is purest in its form, because it doesn't have any heavy metals, it doesn't have any contamination, and the life of it is much longer than the normal water.
So how affordable is this machine, and in fact, how much does it cost actually?
See, the machine, 30 liter machine will come from anywhere 50,000 to 60,000 rupees to 10 lakh to, depending on the capacity of the machine. The 1000 liter machine will cost anywhere up to 10 lakh. But more important, the life of the machine is 15 years. So once you have, the only cost is power. If the government is able to give us a subsidized power, the cost of the water will be less than 1 rupee. And today when people are paying 20, 25, 30 rupees for a liter of water, packaged water, we can give a water which is far superior in its content at 1 rupee a liter, 1 rupee 25 paisa a liter, and that can also help to improve the health of the country. So there is urgent need for creating a new category of water. See, right now we have only two water, that is surface water and the ground water. But we are forgetting that another category of water is air water, which is much purer and much more lasting, and which will help us. See, the right of the water lies with flora and fauna. First right on the light with plants and animals and all that. We are using their water, so they are dying. So if you don't use their water, you use their water, they will use the groundwater. So that way you will be able to bring the atmospheric conservation also will happen that way. So my message is that you try to build a new category, and actually who all can afford should go to air water. Government should also subsidize it, so that we build a new category of water. See, the global warming today happened because whenever the humidity in the atmosphere increases, it have the higher capacity to hold the the heat. So because of it, it can hold the higher heat, the temperatures on the ground increases, and suddenly the humidity become very concentrated, and you will see a large rainfall happening in one small area, and then it won't have rain for many longer time, because that's a phenomenon because of the global warming. So what we can do, when we start using this machine, the humidity become much more distributed. one way. So not only we can save the groundwater and all that, but we can also find a solution to the global warming.
So what is your message to the government authorities and the public in conserving water?
Yeah, exactly. See, because today Telangana, a lot of houses still don't have access to pure drinking water. And as I told you, children are the one who are suffering because their immunity levels are coming down. And once why today we see that what is the single biggest reason of COVID attacking people is attacking the people with a lower humidity. And why is the low humidity? Because your water is not having any important minerals in it. It's a plain water, normal, good, healthy water. Earlier, 10 people used to drink only normal water, but that used to take care of all the immunity issues. Today we don't drink healthy water. So there's an urgent requirement that government start promoting this in all the schools, all the hospitals, especially pregnant women. Today they need magnesium water and there is no electrolytes in the water. So they are drinking normal water. So the contamination, what is happening to the mother is also going on to the child. So children are born with the system which is not very immune. So that's where the immunity system, and we are giving so many antibiotics today. If we have give them access to good drinking water, I'm sure we'll be able to create a healthier Telangana or healthier India and also save a lot of lives in the world. My request to our government is that the government immediately appreciate the need for this technology and support us so that we can start in a small way and go to the entire state and start giving them a very healthier water. See, our Honorable Chief Minister and also rest of the ministers, they are very proactive in building IT technology, pharma industry, but this is also a very important thing. And once Telangana can, or India per se, overall India also, not only can begin with Telangana, rest of the India can become a world leader in water, because the healthier India is very important for us to make India self-reliant. So my request for them is that kindly give us subsidies, allow us to buy few machines from the government thing and support, so that we become a larger company and we can showcase our success to the rest of the world. And all the families also are, my request to the families is that given the importance of the health, please invest in pure water and healthier water and save the water, groundwater, for future generations. We have the responsibility of saving the future generations. We should not consume all the water. Then see, as a part of our responsibility for the future generations, we should build new category of water, use it and save the groundwater so that rest of the future generations also are safe.